Within 5 minutes, my whole world had changed, and I was leaving the office despondent, alone, and unsure of what to do next.
Nurse just looked at me, pointed at the room, and said, "She's in there. She's dead."
I don't believe that they realize the impact they have on how it's said.
I really felt very good about my clinical skills. I had sort of achieved a level where I felt good about myself. And I remember taking care of this critically ill child for probably a month in the hospital. And then one night he was essentially dying. I had nothing else to offer him. I didn't know what to do about that. I didn't know what I was saying. I tripped over myself in language. I made things worse.
As I began to go into neonatology, I knew that I was going to frequently have to break bad news to families, and that was a source of a lot of anxiety for me. I tried to watch as many physicians give bad news as possible, and there were certain patterns between the physicians who did it well and the physicians who didn't do it well. And I started to realize that this is a skill that could actually be taught. The breaking bad news model consists of three components. The first component involves improvisational role-playing using professional actors to teach young physicians how to communicate compassionately bad or tragic news to their patients.
What's unique about this program is that we've given the actors the latitude to react in response to how the resident delivers the news. And they're free to take it in any direction they want.
Well, what kind of parents do you think we are?
I'm sure everyone's cried when they come out of these. They're so real.
This makes it very personalized to the actual abilities of the resident and the psychological things that they bring with them to this interaction.
The second component consists of videotaping scenes with an expert panel of physicians reviewing those scenes live. And the final component, which I believe is the most important component of the Breaking Bad News, is the review of that particular scene immediately following the role-playing session. The participant or the physician reviews that scene with the expert panel.
I think you could have reassured them more that he doesn't seem to be in pain.
And this gives them an opportunity for self-reflection and self-review.
And I also feel like that heightened emotionality of the situation also reinforce the lessons that we were trying to teach.
Right, I mean, we've had hundreds of these conversations, and they're not easy, even when you've been doing it for years.
In most cases, the person breaking the bad or tragic news to the patient is the physician, but also nurses, healthcare workers, social workers can also go through this program.
If there's one thing I've heard people in the community, patients, other family members complain about, is how doctors don't communicate well.
What we found after the success of the Breaking Bad News program is that many institutions came to me and asked if we can bring the program to them. But the reality of medical economics right now is that there's a limited amount of money to pay for the program. And so we started the BBN Foundation to allow people to donate money and support this program.
It will take commitment to the education of medical students, residents, and physicians, and other healthcare workers, so that whatever the news is delivered in a compassionate, empathetic, and effective way.
No, maybe I should have done more.
I think you did exactly what you needed to do.
I think it goes way beyond even what we started out to do, and I'm very excited about what we can do with this program in the future.
And if I don't have the answer to them, I will get them.
Oh, that's great.
Perfect.
That's fantastic.
Okay, I love that.
If we can start training physicians from early on, then maybe 20, 25 years from now, they'll all be trained or be BBN certified.
If the family can go away with that, from feeling that you did everything you could possibly do, you reached out to them in a way that they could understand it, that you don't increase their pain, they'll always have the sadness over the loss or over the diagnosis, but they feel it was a shared experience and that you connected with them at some level, and that will become a very positive experience.
But the truth is that I really did come to medicine to be in a specialty and be in a part of people's lives, to really be able to
talk to them.
It seems almost cruel to give residents training and everything else in medicine. And when this very important thing comes up, really there's no experience and even no guidance. And so I think it's not a luxury to do something like this. It really is a necessity.